A very good morning to all of you students. In this video, we are proceeding our chapter 13 of science, that is playing with magnet. Today we are going to find the both poles of the magnet. As we had learned in previous video that a magnet has two poles, namely south pole and north pole. So today we will try to find how we can locate both poles of a magnet. To find that, we will plot an experiment. So this is a very simple experiment you can do at your home also. So in this experiment, student, we have taken a stand. This is a stand, yes, and then this stand contains a clamp. See, this is a clamp, metallic clamp. So with the clamp of the stand, we had attached a stick. This is a simple stick which we had attached to this clamp. Is it okay? Now we had taken a thread and we had tied the thread. We had tied a bar magnet to the thread, and this thread is attached to this stick. You see, this stick can contain this bar magnet. Yes. Now you just move this bar magnet. You just shake this bar magnet. If you shake the bar magnet, it will try to move like that. Yeah. After moving for some time, when you will leave this undisturbed, it will come to rest. Yeah. And you will see, student, then it will come to rest in a definite direction. One end of the magnet will locate towards this direction, and other will locate towards this direction. Yes. So again and again, whenever you will move this bar magnet and you will leave this bar magnet, and when it will come to rest, always in every experiment it will locate the same direction, this direction and this direction. So first of all, you should know about the different direction of the atmosphere. So how you can locate the different direction of atmosphere? Let me explain. You just take the direction of rising sun. See, this is rising sun here. Yeah. You just keep your face just opposite to this side. Your face is this side. The rising sun is your east direction, and the opposite of that will be the west direction. Your face should be towards west direction. You are looking to west, and then you extend your arms, your right hand and your left hand. Got it? So the direction where your right hand is locating is the north direction, and the direction where your left hand is locating is the south direction. Again, you can plot this experiment in other way also. You just keep your face towards the rising sun. Yes, you are looking at this rising sun. So the rising sun is locating east direction, and your back will locate west direction. Got it? Again, you stretch your arms. This will be your right hand. Yes. The direction where your right hand is locating is your south direction, and the direction where your left hand is locating is actually north direction. Your face is there, your back is there, your right hand and your left hand. But this experiment should be plotted during rising sun. Yeah, when sun rises, then only you can perform the this experiment. And student, I think you all know about the east direction, so you are familiar of the east direction. Then opposite to that direction will be the west direction, and your right hand will locate south direction, and your left hand will locate north direction. Yes. Now see, you are familiar about the direction, so see, always you will see that the magnet is locating towards north and south direction. One end of magnet will locate towards north direction, other end of the magnet will locate towards south direction. So that end of the magnet which is locating towards south is known as south seeking or south pole. Got it? We had got the south pole of the magnet. Yes. So this is our south pole. Which end? Which is locating toward south. Got it? So this is our south pole. And the end which is locating towards north. See, this is locating towards north. It can be known as north seeking. That means it always try to seek north direction. This is north seeking pole or it is north pole. Yes. So this is how we can locate the poles of the magnet. We can take any type of the magnet, whether this is cylindrical magnet, whether this is bar magnet, whether this is horseshoe magnet. If we will try to hang that magnet here, those magnet will locate in the same direction always. Yeah. So this is experiment, and this experiment is plotted to find the poles of the magnet. Now we have got a bar magnet. It is having north pole. We have got, see, a bar magnet. It is having north pole. See, this bar magnet is having north pole and south pole, is it? So now with the help of this north pole and south pole, we will find the different properties of the magnet. What are those properties? Let me explain. So first of all, you take two bar magnets, yes, and in which your directions poles are clearly located. You take the magnet in which you have located both the poles. One bar magnet, we are having north pole and south pole. Other bar magnet, we are having here also north pole and south pole. So student, we are going to know about the different properties of the magnet. So when we will bring these two magnet together, and when we will try to bring, see, I am having this magnet and another magnet. I have brought them together. This is having its north pole and south pole. So what you had seen, that the south pole of the first magnet is near to north pole. So when we bring opposite poles of the magnet together, they get attracted. They just attract each other. So see, if we will bring this type of the magnet together, and if these are two poles, they will attract each other. Simply they will attract each other, just like that. Yeah. So different poles of the magnet attract each other. First point, we have got opposite poles. You should write opposite poles of the magnet of two magnets. What? Opposite poles of two magnets, students, attract each other. Yes. So these attract each other, attract. A-double-T attract. A-double-T-R-A-C-T. Yes. So opposite poles of the magnet attract each other. This is the first property. Now we will try to find another property. This time we will bring same poles of the magnet together. I have brought the magnet such like that. This one. So we will bring same poles of the magnet together. They will repel. If I'll try to bring it, they will go far. Again, I'll try to bring it together, they will go far. Again, I'm doing that, they will go far. So what we had seen, same poles of the magnet repel each other. Second properties, same poles of magnet repel each other. That means they just bring, they just pull. Push, sorry, they just push each other. Yeah, repel. Same poles of two magnets repel each other. Second property regarding the poles of the magnet. Now magnet has two poles. We should add this property also. That is first property was opposite pole attracts each other. Second property same poles repel each other. And third property, this should be your first property. A magnet will always have two property. A magnet will always have two poles. What are those two poles? Namely, south pole and north pole. So, south pole and north pole. Yes. So, this is our three properties of magnet. So you can write these three properties whenever you need it to write properties of magnet. Another property also you can add, that is fourth property here, student. A magnet can attract magnetic material. Magnetic materials. Like, what are the magnetic materials? Iron, nickel, and cobalt. These are magnetic material. Yes. So now we are going to summarize these all properties. This all I had done to give you properties of magnet. So see, properties of magnet can be summarized as, see, properties, because you will have this question of a magnet or only magnet. First property, a magnet can attract magnetic materials. You know about the material which get attracted towards magnet are known as magnetic material. So a magnet can attract magnetic material like, this is common, like iron, nickel, and cobalt. These are magnet. Second property is, a magnet has two poles. Namely, what are those two poles? North pole and south pole. Is it okay? Now third property we had done. Same poles of magnet same poles of two magnet same poles of two magnets repel each other. ये एक दूसरे को दूर भगाते हैं, पास नहीं लाते. सेम पोल्स ऑफ टू मैग्नेट रिपेल ईच अदर. नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी. सो फोर्थ प्रॉपर्टी आर इन अपोजिट पोल्स ऑफ टू मैग्नेट और टू मैग्नेट्स अट्रैक्ट ईच अदर. Is it okay? These are the four properties of magnet. You can add other properties that magnet can be of different shape. A magnet can be of different shapes like bar, cylindrical, circular, horseshoe, etc. We had already read about that in our previous class. So these are, what are those different shapes of the magnet? A magnet can be of different shapes, like bar magnet, cylindrical magnet, circular magnet, and horseshoe magnet, is it? So these are five main properties of the magnet. You should read about that, and you should also learn that, because many times you will have a question to write the different properties of the magnet. Now let us discuss some other points. So yesterday we were reading about a person named Magnes, and he has discovered natural magnet. It was actually form of stone, or you can say a rock. He was moving towards a jungle, taking his herd of animals, and he had just saw, what had he saw? A stone is attracting his iron end of the stick again and again. So he has discovered this natural magnet. This natural magnet is, student, actually known as magnetite. So how you will define magnetite? See, magnetite. Let us try to find the definition of magnet. A natural magnet which is get in nature. A natural magnet is known as magnetite. It is get in nature. Yes. And yesterday also we had done magnetic material and non-magnetic material. So what are magnetic material and non-magnetic material? Student, magnetic materials, the materials which get attracted towards a magnet, that means magnet जिसको भी attract कर पाता है वो कहलाते हैं magnetic. This is our first, this is our second keyword. These are actually answers of keywords also and exercise also. You just try to find. So magnetic materials, the materials which get attracted towards magnet are known as magnetic materials. Yes. For example, iron, nickel, and cobalt. These metals can get attracted towards a magnet. So these are magnetic material. Now try to find non-magnetic material. So the definition will be just opposite. Non-magnetic material, the material which do not get attracted towards magnet, are known as non-magnetic materials. An example, you can take plastic, wood, paper, etc. Yes. So we have completed our chapter 13. You had done very well. In my next class I will explain all the exercise of this chapter, and I'll also give you the solution of the exercise. For today you write the keywords in your fair notebook. All the keywords I had given to you. So simply read the chapter also. That's all for today. Thank you. Have a